to pair food and beer pairing.
What?
Tips. Top 10 tips.
Starting with number 10. Match the intensities. Ensure the intensity of the beer matches the intensity of the food. Light dishes like salads pair really well with light beers like pilsners. Or robust beers like steaks pair with strong beers like stouts.
Number 9. Complement your flavors. Acid loves acid.
I love your hat.
Compliment what? Can I get a fruity IPA for my fruity hat?
Are you going to say your fruity friend?
That would have been better.
You will.
Opportunity squandered. For example, a citrusy IPA can enhance the flavors of a lemony seafood dish. Mm. But as the Belgians say, go in saison, maybe a citrusy IPA can enhance your hot wings.
Ooh, hot wings. And to contradict that, I'm going to suggest contrasting flavors. Sometimes contrasting flavors create a delightful experience. A sweet dish like chocolate cake can pair really wonderfully with like a bitter stout because they help balance each other out instead of pairing it with something sweet again that now you just kind of have this overload of sweet. So instead, it kind of balances each other out.
Number 7, always consider the bitterness. The bitterness of the beer should be balanced with the dish. Highly bitter beers are best paired with spicy foods, i.e. that's why we keep bringing up IPAs. The bitter, the better, the butter, the better, the acid that loves it. Tame the heat, while less bitter beers are suitable for lighter eats.
I didn't know you could talk so fast.
That might be the fastest I've ever spoken in my life.
It was like real words, too. That was amazing. It wasn't just like the blah, 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 blah. It was like real words. Wow. So number 6. I'm going to try to compete with that. I use beer in cooking. It pairs because it's in there. Incorporate it into the cooking process. This creates a seamless flavor between your dish and your drink. For example, using a porter in the marinade of your grilled meats to enhance the pairing together.
Yum. Number 5, balance the sweetness, right? Continuing on that train, it's all about balance. Sweet beers, fruit lambics, milk stouts, they pair with salty and spicy foods, right? Because you're creating a balance, and this is how it's really important of whether or not you're going to do it well. But don't worry about doing it well, just do it to where you like it. Yep. The sweetness balances out the saltiness or spiciness, and that's where that harmonious blend comes into effect.
Number 4?
I think 4. Yep.
Seems like a good guess. Mind the mouthfeel. This is kind of something that I feel like gets overlooked, but the texture of the mouthfeel should complement the dish. Creamy beers like nitro stouts pair well with other creamy dishes.
Makes sense.
Crisp carbonated beers pair really well with fried food. You do like the big pilsner with the fried food and the hot and the heat and the extra really highly carbonated bubbles with the heat and the richness of the oil are just incredible together.
I was just thinking the next time I show up to a party, I get invited to a party, I'm going to bring that marshmallow salad with some Guinness. And I'm going to be the life of the party. I bet that's fucking awesome. All right.
The party I want to opt out of.
It's so good. I love marshmallow. So. All
right. Actually, this made me, I was like, I really want a pilsner with a mozzarella stick right now.
Sounds good too. All right. Just getting hungrier and hungrier over here. But not hangrier, just hungrier.
Colder.
Number 3, we're going to remember to match seasonal and regional cuisines, right? Remember where you are. Remember what time of the year it is. It's going to play a big part into the dishes that you're pairing with.
Yep.
Same region. A German Pilsner pairs not just with a mozzarella stick, but definitely with a bratwurst and some sour.
A bratwurst of bratwurst.
I mean, that sounds like a good Saturday night to me. How do you jungle that? So can't talk about balance. How contradicting is a bra full of sausage?
Well, what a great way to get your food presented. It'd be so silly. You'd be so confused. How many wings would you like? A D cup.
I'm going to the double D, please.
How many wings come in a D cup? About like 15 on each side, so 30 wings total.
I would like the Wing Wednesday special, please. All right.
Okay, sorry. Bringing it in.
German Pilsners, bratwurst, Belgian jubels, Belgian stew. Believe it or not.
Weird.
And seasonality, right? Like, yeah. Look at what is available and in season at your local grocery store, your farmer's market, right? What are your local breweries producing this yeah. week, that week, the next week, January, February, March, April, September? It does not matter. Pair them together.
Yeah.
Right? We talked about supply and demand. If there's an oversupply of things, turns out, hopefully it's not because there's a backlog of it. It means because it's in season. Yep. It makes sense. That's why you should go after
it. I always like the advice of if it grows together, it goes together. And that's kind of the same concept, right? Because brewers are going to be using the same things, exactly what you're saying, that you're using. That's exactly what you're saying. So it grows together, it goes together.
I was just thinking, do sausages grow with bras? Because
they might now. Can't wait to see.
I was trying to look you in the eye. Till all I could
Sam's
see
AI image is going to be atrocious
this,
of that.
This H white cup, like classic white underwire bra, which is just sausages
oozing out.
Oh, man.
Oh, goodness. Oh, man. All right, number two. Pick your beer first. Depending on the beers you choose will directly influence the food that you pair it with. Lagers go with wings. IPAs go with spicy food. We're going on these basics because, again, they're simple. They're easy to go. If you want to get more advanced, hit us up. Read a book. Do all the things. There's more advanced, but we're kind of hitting
talk
on the...
Talk to Chef Jared.
Talk to Chef Jared. But yeah, pick your beer first.
All right. And number one, most importantly, just like good advice, life advice, not lice on life. Number one, experiment and have fun.
Have fun.
Do not be afraid to experiment with different pairings. The best way to learn is what works best for you. Try various combinations.
Yeah.
See what you enjoy the most. It could be a bra full of sausages, or it could just simply be a lager and IPA with some spicy wings. Yeah. Keep an open mind and have fun with it.
Have fun with it.
Dear God, laugh. The secret to life is a good sense of humor.
And
enjoy
some good
it.
Food, in my opinion.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's such a great piece in there. Like, I don't overly like IPAs with really a whole lot of food. They're not my go-to. That's just not like my jam for it. So
the curry is pretty good.
Yeah. And I get there are some things, but they tend to be like a lot of meat. And so
yeah,
because I'm not
fair.
Eating, like, I just don't tend to like those. But it doesn't mean they're bad. It's just not my jam. So experiment. Just because what we're recommending doesn't work for you doesn't mean something else will. And if there's a pairing you love, share it with us. Let us know.
That's the goal here. We want to hear what you have to say.
We covered everything from matching intensity and flavors to considering mouthfeel and regional cuisines.
Amen to that. Remember, we ended with it. We're saying it again. The key to any great pairings is balance, complementing or contrasting flavors, yep. And most importantly, have fun with the process.
Beep, beep, beep.
Don't be afraid. Get out there. Get out of your comfort zone. Have a good time.
Have a good time. We hope these tips inspire you to create your own memories and dining experiences with your favorite brews. And if you want to experience some knowledge, with your brews and bites, make sure you hit up Sam at Shut Up and Drink Trivia. Not What's Up and Drink Trivia. Shut Up and Drink
Could
Trivia.
Be a subsidiary.
And if you're a establishment looking for trivia, hit him up. He's the jam. He does lots of cool stuff and lots of fun, unique things. So
it's also a riot to hang out with.
And he's a good
guaranteed time. To have a fun time.
Truth. I agree with that.
Yes.